Bulan.
Ang 5,000 pamilya o 66,000 individual ang apektado sa pagkukupit ng bagyong Agaton sa Region 8.
Good day! I am Mary Ayush Gail T. Briones and along with my groupmates, Joan Irai, Margie Ligayo, and Chriselle Valencia of STEM 12 St. Rose of Viterbo, we have conducted several interviews with the key influential people in our chosen barangay regarding about the vulnerability, exposure, and hazard that are present in the said community, and identifying the barangay's preparations and projects that has been implemented and future possible projects that will be implemented. But first, here's a quick recap about hazard exposure and vulnerability. A hazard can be defined as a dangerous phenomenon, human activity, or condition that may cause loss of life, injury, or other health impacts, property damage, loss of livelihoods and services, social and economic disruption, or environmental damage.
For exposure, it refers to people, property, systems or other elements present in hazard zones are thereby subject to potential losses. Exposure is a necessary but not sufficient determinant of risk. It is possible to be exposed but not vulnerable. However, to be vulnerable to an extreme event, it is necessary to also be exposed. And lastly is vulnerability. It refers to the characteristics and circumstances of a community, system, or asset. There are many aspects of vulnerability arising from various physical, social, economic, and environmental factors. Examples may include poor design and construction of buildings, lack of public information and awareness, and disregard for wise environmental management. Vulnerability varies significantly within a community and over time.
Recap time is over, and as a resident of Barangay Nubuswang, I would like to know and be assured that me and my family will be safe when calamities occur. And to answer my questions, my team and I interviewed a very important person who has the knowledge about the hazard and implementations of disaster risk management within the Barangay of Nubuswang, Calibo, Aklan. She is the kagawad of our barangay, Mrs. Luceline Matanga.
Hello, good morning. I am Sangguniang Barangay Member, Luceline Imatanga o Barangay Nubuswang. And I am here to cater whatever nga purpose man na i-visit iyo makaroon sa barangay home.
So for the question po, why is it important to know the vulnerability, exposure, and hazard within your community?
Of course, it is important to know the vulnerability, exposure, and hazard within our community in order for the Sangguniang Barangay to act on those matters that are existing. Para siyempre doon magbabase kang ano ro dapat obrahon, ano ang kailangan gawin ng barangay in case of disaster. Yung mga kahinaan, yung mga pwedeng mag-cause ng mga damages sa barangay, ang mga hazards na pwedeng mangyari, kailangan malaman talaga yung mga barangay.
For the second question po, how do you prevent the worst from happening?
Siyempre, once na na-identify ng Sangguniang Barangay, headed by our punong barangay, yung mga existing na vulnerability ay at exposure and hazard sa aming barangay, siyempre, magkakaroon ng action at hindi lang naman na alone is the Sangguniang Barangay will act on this matter. We have linkages on other local government units that, like the MLGU, the Municipal Local Government Units. Of course, the provincial government. And when we are speaking of those vulnerabilities in terms of disasters, the Sangguniang Barangay has existing also Barangay Disaster Risk Reduction Management Council with the linkage on to the municipal, local, DRRMC also.
So for the third question po, what are the prudent practices, protective facilities, and equipment necessary to minimize the risk and exposure of hazard?
About the prudent practices, the Sangguniang Barangay, as I have said, has existing Barangay Disaster Risk Management Council who are working together, acting in terms of occurrence of disasters in the barangay. They have the planning body. We have the planning body. We have the Barangay Disaster Risk Management plan, 3-year plan, and we also have, and basing on those plans, we already have prepared some actions. Like, as you remember, the vulnerability of our people, we have identified situ bayside, simply sa mga baha-baha o sa mga ano nga ron ay the National Housing Authority ay nag-allocate man para panda for the relocation at andang mga panimagay. If ever the vulnerability ay hindi man panat dito taling ma-solve, kundi ay ma-minimize yung natol. The relocation of some residents, just like if 300 families, we have relocated almost 24 or more. And that's because through also the help of our LGUs, the municipal local government, through the municipal mayor, barangay, the MSWD, and the NHA. The barangay also has existing barangay evacuation center sa mga bagyo, sa mga in case man it fire, typhoons, ay ato nga mga ta pamuyo. Our constituents ay meron silang evacuation center na pupuntahan. Our New Buswang Barangay Evacuation Center, as you can see, multipurpose siya sa pavement doon sa taas. Ato lang nga bayside nga multipurpose pavement, meron din doon. The New Buswang Elementary School. At yung naka-tie up din tayo sa mga private households, two-story buildings nga nag-offer man voluntarily sa andang mga neighbors, mga neighboring houses nga nag-evacuate during disasters.
So for the fourth question po, what are the projects that you have already established for the vulnerability, exposure, and hazard that may occur within the community?
As I have answered niya a while ago, no, parang may relation din siya sa number 3. Idagdag ko lang na about sa mga projects, idugang ko sa halimbawa sa mga prevention and mitigation about sa disaster-related problems. Aro barangay man ay flood ay gina-improve natin do drainage system, gina-continue itang guni ang barangay pag-implementar at construction of drainage, clearing and declogging it mga drainage canals to for the continuous flow it drainage system para ma-minimize ro pag stagnant it mga water nga ron during typhoons or mga stormy seasons or mga heavy rains nga nagakose it floods sa mga low level or low lying areas. As you can see, naumpisahan yun nangyani yung mga construction of drainage, di ba? Sa mga interior nga mga subdivisions, ito di ka to sa may Magdalena, naman, inaubraman, along the provincial roads.
Fifth question po, are you rest assured that you're fully prepared and these projects can really help the people of Barangay New Buswang?
Yes, of course. The barangay is fully prepared. Of course, the barangay cannot stand alone by its own. We need the help of other government agencies, kapin pa sa mga technical na assistance. During disaster, in case no sa mga disasters nga ron, ay nag-rescue, may mga rescue operation, ay we need mga heavy equipment, which the barangay has no own heavy equipment. Araw mga trees nga managakatumba, nga, like for example, araw mga kahoy nga that is a sardos nga na-fall down during typhoon, ay kinangan natin karon do technical assistance man it iba, just like mga chainsaw, heavy equipment nga ma-pull out do yun. Siyempre, of course, initially do, Barangay Disaster Risk Reduction Management Council is initiating that kind of matter. And aside from that, of course, as I have said kaina, hay may ato mga evacuation center. The barangay also, if there are evacuees, the barangay also will be purchasing during calamities mga relief and goods. The barangay abingaron hay may ato nga 5% calamity funds nga ginagamit naton. 70% of that will be utilized before the disaster, and 30% will be utilized during as disaster response and relief and rehabilitation. Kaya before gabaka manggali kita it mga emergency medical supplies, during hay mga relief goods, mga bugas, mga iba nga mga kagamitan nga pwede na damagamit sa evacuation center ito nga mga evacuees. As you can see no, sa pang-COVID nga nga pandemic nga unexpectedly gida ay nag-abot katon, nag-purchase man dumabarangay naton sa mga gitao sa mga COVID victims, mga COVID families, kasi hindi man natong tanan dun ma-pop up ban nga every household ay tawang gitna to groups. We have plans, but also the challenges is that we lack funds, limited of funds. Although the barangay has funds, but also of minimal amount that we can really exactly fully implement those projects or moderately lang.
So for the last question po, what are your future plans or projects in mind right now?
Future plans, of course, previously and presently, kung ano man do barangay disaster risk reduction management plan it among barangay hay among dun nga igapadayo padayunon, will continue to implement, will continue the planning, and if possible will do additional nga ikadagdag naton. The barangay is aiming to own multi-cab service ugali sa ibang sa government code ruling hay hindi kita makapurchase out of our calamity fund, but the barangay initially hay nagbudget yun for the year 2022 makabalkaray kita it multi-cab out of general fund for multi-purpose use. Partly we can use that for the service in barangay ang gamit man naton in case of disasters and calamities. Doon, we will continue the declogging, clearing of drainage, construction of drainage, purchase of emergency medical supplies and materials, relief goods during disaster. Siyempre, may ato mang mga rehab, improvement of mga structures in case nga ma-damage during the calamity or disasters. Speaking ron, gaban gid man abiya sa aton hay ro gapatago gid lang hay mga bagyo no, mga bagyo nga ron agbaha ro mga fire nga ron ay parang rare lat agid man gakatabo ya sa aton ay ro yun hay ro yun don nga ring pandemic nga ron nga ni hay ro barangay man hay na nagiging ang recipient man kita nga ro barangay man hay ding ano masabilo ang recipient it local MLGU or municipal local government unit nga iya, ibutang man ang daro COVID facility. Dikara naton ibutang man dikara sa second floor. Ina may part, dikara nga ina may ibutang. About in case man sa mga quarantine, hani, magamit man kita bisan pila lang ang bilong.
Thank you so much, Ma'am Luz Nalimatanga, for giving us some insights about the plans and the projects that Barangay New Buswang have already established to minimize the effects of this exposure and hazards that may occur within our community. And also, for the future plans and future projects that are now being established to improve the safety of our community. For our next video, we will now show you the projects and the plans that Ma'am Matanga have mentioned earlier.
As a resident of Barangay Nyubuswang, I am assured that me, my friends, and my family are very safe here in our barangay, knowing that our barangay have these plans and projects. For our next interview, we choose a parent and also a resident of Barangay Nyubuswang to react to these plans and projects that Barangay Nyubuswang have already established.
As a parent, given the projects and plans that Barangay Nyubuswang have established, are you assured that you and your family are safe?
Hello, good morning. I am Marian Ikeyu, a mother of two. I'm 18 and 10. With regards to your question, as a parent, the existing and ongoing projects here in our barangay will give and or explore more options and that make our barangay a safer place to live. But as for me, this is not a single effort. Everybody in this community should participate and coordinate in implementation of this project, especially for the future of our dear sons and daughters. God bless Nyubuswang. Thank you.
Ngayon, bibisitahin namin ang isa sa mga sikat na tourist spot at itinalaga na most successful mangrove reforestation project dito sa Pilipinas, ang Bakawan Eco Park. Ang proyekto na ito ay sinimulan noong 1990 ng lokal na gobyerno at iba pang non-local government. Ang dating maputik na baybayin ng Barangay Nyubuswang ay ginawang reforestation site para maiwasan ang pagbaha at storm surges sa komunidad.
Good afternoon. Ako si Riza D. Special, Treasurer ES sa Bakawan Eco Park.
So yung unang question po, does this mangrove trees have a huge contribution for the safety of the community of Barangay Nyubuswang when it comes to upcoming hazard or disasters?
Oo, mabaho gid ang abulig ra yung mangrove trees ES sa community it Nyubuswang kasi kung magbasko baro ruhangin or magbahay, hindi ka diretso ro baha or ruhangin yung maka-affect sa mga kabagayan dahil ginaharang it mangroves. So doon ka importante ang doon do sa bilog nga mabaho nga bulig it mangroves iya sa Nyubuswang. Bukod yung it sa Nyubuswang kasi kumbaga dalaman do ibang mga like old Buswang. So, yun.
Second question po. It is known that mangrove trees prevent floods from happening. How can you preserve these trees?
Actually, gaano kami gariplant. Gina, pag may mga patay nga mga mangroves nga ron, amon doon nga gina-prone, ginabuo naman doon patay, tapos gatanom dahil kami ituman. May amon man nga mga eco-police nga gabantay sa mga illegal logging para ma-prevent do pag pinuto it mga mangroves. Daily man, may garubing man kami kung yung mga staff man namon iya, ginamonitor namon kung may mga illegal activities nga gakatabo iya inside the park.
For the third question po, ano rin pinaka-worst ng haubra at isang kabagyo na naka-apekto gid iya sa Bakawan? Agalin do mga paghahanda ang changes nga kapatigayon pagkatapos it bagyo. Like, ano po yung na-realize nyo after?
Okay, so sa bilog nga pinaka-malubha or pinaka-maano nga naubra it worst nga haubra it bagyo ay ito nga nga bagyo nga Frank Ursula nga kabaabog gid ang mga trees nga natumba. So doon doon nga pero hay bisan abo nga trees nga hao nga nagatumba hay kumbaga ro damage nga ni sa community sang kiliat dahil bin sagap tanan it mga mangroves. So sa bilog garden hay doon doon abo-abo ang mga mangrove nga kinahanglan namo nga magano man ito man mag-replant baga aga mga area dayon nga may mga area baga nga wa pahatam ni namon heading di anuhan dayon nya tamnan agud nga mas magapad pag idro mangroves iya agud mas abo pagid nga mabuligan do daya nga project nga ra nga mangrove forest iya sa Nyubuswang.
For the last question po, ang laro mga materials nga ginamit sa pag-ubra it dawan, lightweight po ba siya or heavyweight? And paki-explain po kung bakit ito po yung ginamit yung gamit.
Among nga dalan nga or ginatawag naman nga boardwalk ay among ginagamit is bamboo ang wood. So bamboo ang wood kasi doy matarong gina-advise kami dati nga gamito namon wa kami gagamit it mga concrete bala like mga semento na doy yung advice kami it DNR nga hindi kami pwede nga mag-put up it concrete bala materials iya sa solid part kaya doon doon mo niya ginagamit nga gamit naman sa amon niya dalan or boardwalk ay bamboo at ay mogin ang kahoy.
And that's it for our video. We hope you all enjoyed and learned new things. Always remember that we all need to work together to prevent these hazards and exposures from happening. Because the reason why this exists is because the lack of concern and activities to take care of our Mother Nature. Let's all be responsible and avoid doing things that might destroy our nature. And lastly, always be prepared for disasters that may occur. Let it be moderate to extreme disasters. Ang taong laging handa, ligtas sa anumang sakuna. This has been the students of Grade 12 STEM A of Aklan Catholic College, now signing off.